and marriage, love and marriage, go together like a horse and carriage. This,
oh, Molly, tell you, can you come in and take that dress off before you ruin
you can't
it?
Have
now, come on, we've got to go on.
The other, love and marriage, love and marriage, it's an institute you can't disparage. Ask the local gentry, and they will say it's elementary. Try to separate them. It's an illusion. Try, and you will only come to this conclusion. Love and marriage, go together like a horse and carriage. Dad was told by mother, you can't have one, you can't have none, you can't have one without the other. Separate them, it's an illusion. Try, and you will only come to this conclusion. Love and marriage, go together like a horse and carriage. Dad was told by mother, you can't have one. You can't have one without the other.
Oh, sorry, everyone. Bloody Land Rover broke down again. Oh, pardon me, Vicar.
Is this who's giving you away?
Take that bridesmaid's dress off.
Well, in a minute.
See, this is what I mean. We've got 5 days to go to this wedding and there's a lot to do. I don't want any mistakes.
It's like having Boadicea in your kitchen.
Who's Boadicea?
A very scary woman indeed.
She ate children who wouldn't take their bridesmaid's dresses off.
Nasty.
I don't want any excuses. Any apologies? We've got to be on time.
It's not my fault the Land Rover broke down.
We've all got to pull our weight, Brian. Including you, Droopy Jaws.
I was there.
Thanks for putting yourself out.
With a face like a wet weekend in Llandudno. What on earth's the matter, Sarah?
Nothing. Sarah, has anybody asked you to marry them?
Can we get rid of Marcus first?
Marriage is a bourgeois construction aimed solely at legitimising monogamous relationships.
Look, this is what I'm saying. We've all got to stick together. No squabbling. It may not be the wealthiest family on the planet, but we are not short of imagination. I want Marcus and Celeste's wedding day to be the happiest day of their life. And if anyone's got different ideas, they've got me to answer to. Right. Any questions? No, but Marcus, your dad's got something he wants to say to her.
Excuse me. I'll leave my beer alone. Beautiful evening.
I'm so sorry. I don't know what came over me. I haven't thought much about my dad, but suddenly it seems really important.
What do you remember about him?
Not very much. I remember him playing tag with me in the garden. I think I remember that anyway. Maybe it's just wishful thinking.
What happened to him?
He met someone else. One of the neighbours, which was quite an achievement, as we only had three. He left my mother to bring me up on her own.
It happens, I suppose.
In all those years, I've never even got so much as a birthday card from him.
I'm afraid I don't quite know how to say this.
Say what?
Well, I'm afraid when you marry Marcus, you get me as your father. I know, life's cruel and full of misery.
Can I call you Dad and everything?
Only if you let me give you away on your wedding day. Good. Beautiful evening, isn't it?
Exam results again?
Yeah, a bit nervous.
Saves me a trip anyway. There you go. See you later.
Have a look.
Very impressive.
Director of Addison's son.
You must do. You are the marketing director of Addison's son.
Do people still wear shoulder pads?
They probably do in Devon.
Have you spoken to Sarah?
About what?
Oh, I don't know. It's just she's taken the dogs for a walk 3 mornings in a row.
She's up to no good, I'll be bound.
You just worry about yourself, madam. Do your jobs and help Daddy and Marcus. Wish me luck.
Yeah, good luck. Having just lost one contract, we could really do with finding another. So, no pressure, eh?
Thank you, Ben. Oh, hello, Kitty. Come to me, Kitty, come on. Oh, no.
I say get the pesticide.
No, but...
Don't you talk back to me.
I'm not just saying, I don't think we need to put chemicals everywhere. If you just let me weed the area...
Right, if I tell you to jump for you, ask how I... You don't give me none of your lip, or I'll knock you into the middle of next week. Do you hear?
I'll just put pesticides on me, it'll be quicker.
Don't you cheeky little...
Excuse me?
Can I help you?
It's not the 19th century. You can't just hit people.
I can look after myself, thank you.
That's not the point.
I'll tell you what the point is. He's sacked.
So you were all set for the wedding?
You mean my bourgeois construction?
You want me?
I pointed out to him that the roses around the cottage door fantasy wasn't for everyone.
Well, like roses around the pressing flat above a butcher's.
Well, your own little love nest.
Are we still off your stag?
Oh, you bet.
Oh, you want to come to the movies tomorrow night? No, a few of us are going. Pizza afterwards.
I can't, I'm skint.
Skint? You can't be, you're working here every hour God made.
Sarah. Collect those empty glasses, can you please?
You know where he lives, but you've never been there.
He was like the bogeyman when I was growing up. Once when I was 13, I sat outside his house.
Did you see him?
Him and his new wife and his new kids. I think he saw me, but his wife shooed them all inside.
But you still think he should know you're getting married?
I don't know. It would kill Mum. What do you think I should do?
Whatever you do, I'll be right beside you.
I quite like you, you know.
I might even marry you.
Isn't it to put you off your port scratchings?
So let me get it straight. You went out to get a contract and came home with a scruffy lad instead.
His name's Paul. He was getting bullied by this gardener bloke, so I just sort of helped out.
You mean you stuck your oar in?
He's a nice lad, Brian. If we get him on the work experience, we can afford him, can't we?
I don't know.
He said we needed extra help.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, all right. I suppose we could do with another pair of hands. Anyway, where is everyone? I can actually hear myself think. It's very disconcerting.
Well, better get used to it. They'll all be gone eventually. First Marcus. Then it'll be Sarah. Finally Molly.
Hey!
Where is she anyway?
Radio Devon with Judy Spires.
BBC Radio Devon.
And it's a lovely sunny day across most of Devon today. It's mainly dry with maximum temperatures of 21 degrees Celsius and 69 degrees Fahrenheit, but slightly cooler on the northern coast.
Is that them?
No. Sarah?
What?
You're very nervous.
So would you be if children kept sneaking up on you?
What's in the letter?
None of your business. Go away.
Don't think you can hide anything from Mum.
Don't you dare say anything to her, you little snoop.
Don't need to. Mum's all-seeing and all-knowing.
My son took your order, and he shouldn't have done.
I'm off, Brian.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Godfrey, but we don't deliver to Bristol. I wish we could help. I really do, but we can't. Oh. I'm sorry. Yeah. Bye.
What are you doing?
Cancelling orders.
Cancelling? What on earth for?
What he's done. Taunton, 60 miles away. Tiverton, 35. We can't afford to be doing this in time or in fuel.
Have you discussed this with Marcus?
No.
Well, don't you think you should?
Did he discuss it with me?
Right, calm down, Brian. Sort it out with Marcus when he gets back.
Nothing to sort out.
That's him.
Hello. I'm Celeste.
I know who you are. What are you doing here?
Who is she, Dad?
Nobody. Run inside now. Go on.
It's not nobody. She's your daughter.
Oh, I didn't mean...
I want to speak to you.
What do you want?
This is Marcus. We're getting married.
So, you've told me. I'm very pleased for you both. I hope you both be very happy together. Now, if that's all...
You are unbelievable, you are. I've had the courage to come here and you can't even be bothered to speak to me.
This ain't the time or the place.
It is, actually. It's exactly the right time.
I'm sorry, I got kids to look after.
Leave it, Celeste. It's not worth it.
I think you'll agree that that is the best leaf spinach this side of...
It's
good.
We think so. If you'd like to place an order.
I like the produce. The company I bought from before didn't understand cooking. They didn't understand the rhythm of a place like this.
Well, I'm a bit of a cook myself.
Please, don't interrupt me. I demand flexibility, intelligence, anticipation.
We're all of those.
So you say.
You said you liked our vegetables. Are you interested or not?
Interested, definitely.
Good.
But I'm also interested in several other companies.
So you're going to make your choice?
Two of the other companies were so committed to their produce that they wanted to spend an evening working in my kitchen.
Work in here?
It's up to you, of course.
Excuse me.
At least I tried. I was silly to think he'd want to know in the first place.
At least you know where you stand now. I think he's a bloody idiot and you're well shot with him.
I know. It must be brilliant to have a real dad.
He has his moments.
I'm going to hug my mum till her ribs crack.
Home. Perhaps not.
Bridgewater, Taunton, Bristol. Bristol, have you any idea what it would cost us in fuel and time to get to Bristol? Can we turn this bloody music off if you can call it that?
Obviously, we'd have to build up trade in those areas and make it worthwhile.
It's just the two of us, Marcus. We're not a multinational. We're a father and son trying to make ends meet.
There's more to life than making ends meet, Dad. I'm about to get married.
Yeah, I had noticed.
I have to be involved in a business that supports me and Celeste. It gives us a future.
This is why we're going to open a farm shop.
But when? All Addie's money's gone in doing this place up.
When I'm ready, you've absolutely no right to go behind my back.
I'm not a child.
Then don't act like one.
Forget it.
What'd you say? Oi! Don't you walk away from me!
What's going on?
Ask him.
Right.
You can call every person on the customer list.
Email. We in the modern world call it email.
I don't care what you call it. It's your mess. You sort it.
Do you know what your problem is, Dad?
Marcus.
What, other than being in business with a child?
You've got no imagination. No vision. You're stuck in your one way of how things get done and you refuse to take advice. You've stopped learning. And if you stop learning, you're finished.
That's enough, Marcus.
Oh, no. Let him finish.
You pretend it's one for all and all for one, but it isn't, is it, Dad? It's you imposing your views on how you want us to live down here. You hate it if someone has a better idea than yours.
Rubbish! What about that patch oil that you grow? Which will rot where it stands inside a month.
It's up and growing. Look, Dad, we're stuck. Stuck in a rut, and I'm sick of it. We have to expand or we'll die. We need the money, and we need it now. At least one of us is doing something about it.
What do you mean by that?
I've applied for a loan from the Enterprise Trust.
You've done what?
Marcus, you should have discussed it with your dad first.
Why? It wasn't his idea, so he would have turned it down as a matter of course. Anyway, they've given it to us.
Well, you can go and tell them we don't need it.
Tell them yourself!
He doesn't mean it, Brian.
Oh, yes, he does.
To 8:29 and time to take a look at the region's weather forecast
for the next 5 days. Looking towards the weekend, the weather will be changeable with sunny spells.
Changeable? I hate when they say that, it means I don't know. Sarah, will you take a deposit round to the vicar? I think we should have the village all on standby. Oh, and Molly, can you weed the lawn?
Can't Paul do it?
Why can't you?
I'm busy.
Busy doing what?
Okay, I'll weed the lawn.
Thank you. And Marcus,
will you tell Dad that I'm planting the next lot of pak choi this morning?
Tell him yourself. He's sitting right there.
Right, I'm off.
Where are you going?
To the bank. Will you tell Marcus I've got my own way of raising capital?
This is ridiculous. We've got a wedding in 2 days.
See you later.
Oh, no, you don't. I'm going with you.
We've been down here 3 years now, and well, we think we've pretty much got the hang of it. We got a bigger property, but I want to start utilising it.
Your mum's money.
I inherited some money from my mother, and we invested it all in a business, but we haven't quite got enough finance to complete the farm shop we're planning.
We're also thinking of turning one of the outhouses into a B&B. I could run that.
If you remember, we came to you for a loan when we first moved down here.
Oh, I remember.
I wouldn't blame you for being a bit reluctant to lend us the money.
We did loan you the money, and your overdraft has been right at its limits ever since.
So you're making lots of money from us.
Brian.
It's different now. That's what I'm saying. I've got a market for me veg, and me box scheme's starting to flourish.
I see the money from the hotel has stopped.
We're working on that.
Mr. Addis, the problem from my point of view is that if I give you another loan, the only difference will be is that you're 3 years older and 3 years deeper in debt.
That's a nice summary of our life down here, isn't it?
Just ignore O'Brien. She sees life in columns of red and black. Not in love and achievement. What you need to do is to talk to Marcus, sort out this stupid argument.
When he apologises, I'll talk to him.
Brian.
What's all this?
We've got the chairs we want, look.
I was told to deliver the chairs to Mr. Addis at Silverdale Farm, and that's what I've done.
What's going on?
The chairs I ordered turned up, but so have these.
I ordered these chairs.
Well, how was I to know?
They're much better price.
These are much better quality.
It's my money.
Our money.
Do you want them or not?
Yes.
No.
How about this?
I don't know, Sarah. It's not quite right, is it?
What do you think?
That's perfect.
And I'm sure I saw another one.
How much is it?
£250.
Is that going to be okay? I wish you didn't have to buy it. Makes me feel dreadful.
Bridesmaids always have to cough up. It's traditional.
Paul. Leave that for now and give me a hand to put some lights up in the garden.
Marcus wanted me to finish the patio first.
Learn one thing, Paul, and we'll get along just fine. Me boss, Marcus' son.
Yes, Mr. Addis.
Good rain on the radio.
I've got a clue, Mrs. A.
I had the post, didn't I?
I found this one on the floor of the van. Sorry about that.
Congratulations. You've won £1 million. Another millionaire.
Terrible, isn't it? You're the 30th millionaire I've delivered to today. Any news for Sarah yet?
Sarah?
I see her every morning these days. Like a cat on an hot tin roof, she is.
Waiting for,
exam results.
Exam results, yeah. No news yet.
Oh, well. Fingers crossed, eh?
See you later.
Bye, Sid. It is my problem.
I can't just stand by while they drag you off to prison, can I?
You're exaggerating. All students are in debt.
I know that.
It's not like when you're in college. They expect us to get into debt.
Is this debt to do with books? Or is it to do with buying fancy sports cars and wearing trendy tops?
It's not a fancy sports car. It's a clapped out old MG. I have to get around. I have to live.
Live? Live? Read these, Ivana Trump, then tell me I'm exaggerating.
What's going on? I can hear you two halfway across Somerset.
This is what's going on. I can't believe you've been so stupid, Sarah. You're at university. You're meant to be intelligent. Not running up a debt the size of a small third world country.
Some of this is not true, Sarah.
Dad, it's rent, books, food, bills. I can't work during term time because I'm studying too hard. They give you credit cards. Everyone relies on them.
It's £4,000.
Pay it off.
How? Tell me how! I suppose we'll have to bail you out.
Hello?
I don't want your money. I won't take it!
We thought we'd come a bit early, see if we could help.
Feeling?
Terrible.
This is for you.
What's this?
Pay it into your bank. It'll at least ease your interest payments a little bit. The rest's up to you.
But you don't have this sort of money.
I've got a bit tucked away. It's my Addie Rainy Day Fund.
Nan left that to you.
Well, roof hasn't blown off. Land Rover's still going. And you and Molly aren't getting married, are you? So the money's yours. Because you need it.
Does Mum know?
I'm waiting for the right moment on that one.
I'll pay you back. Promise. I'm so sorry, Dad.
I know you are. Some breakfast.
Are they all down there?
The entire Inquisition. Excuse me.
Is everyone excited about the wedding? I know we are.
What are we doing for your stag, Marcus?
Don't know, Grandad.
I remember on my stag night, the night before I married your grandmother.
People don't want to hear about you piddling in your shoe at breakfast, Richard.
He's not having a stag night, because we can't afford it.
Go on and on about it, why don't you?
Mum?
Yes, Molly?
Nothing.
Please, 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 please.
Molly!
sure you don't want to swap with me? I'd much rather spend a night in the kitchens from hell than go on this end night.
No. You go. You'll enjoy yourself.
Coward.
Look, this is work. It comes before any stag night. Anyway, you'll have a ball once you get there.
Me and Sarah? I'd rather get shouted at by a highly strung chef.
Go on, Faith.
No, you go on. Have you talked to Marcus yet?
I'll toss you for it. Heads or tails.
It's not a very mature way to settle a family argument, is it? Tails. Excuse me, I'm going to the loo.
Just tell her you're sorry. Now, why didn't I think of that?
She'll come around. Just give her time. Maybe she won't.
Thank you very much.
I'm just saying, to be stabbed in the heart by an ungrateful daughter is a terrible thing.
Mum, I just spoke to him.
So was your husband at the stag then, Jean?
Bludgeon it.
My wife does most of the cooking, I just do the growing.
Rhythm. Rhythm. All is rhythm and precision.
Yeah.
What now?
Are you sure, Chef?
Why?
I think I might have chopped my finger off.
The thing about marriage is that you've got to put your foot down straight away. Show them who's boss.
You make them sound like puppies.
That's a good analogy. You take them for a walk now and again, feed them, water them. They'll adore you forever. Let them have their head too early. And they'll eat your slippers and dirty in the garden.
And neuter them at the first opportunity.
Not all men are like that, thank God. When you take Brian, for instance.
Brian's no different from any of the others. He huffs and puffs about the place, but it's you who runs that family.
I'd like to raise a glass, if I may. To a woman who brought me up without any man around. Who was always strong and decent and always there for me. My mum, Jean.
Oh, Jean.
The best mum in the world.
Digger Brian? Did you get the contract then?
What do you think? Everyone having fun?
Oh, it's like Sodom and Gomorrah in here.
All right, who's going to say it first?
I don't know what you mean.
I'm sorry. I should have told you I was widening the delivery area. I still think we should be looking to expand, but I should have talked it over with you first. As for the other things I said, nobody could work harder than you, Dad, or care more about his kids. I was just angry and I tried to hurt you. I'm sorry. I won't want to hurt you for the world.
And in the blue corner?
I won't pretend I wasn't a bit upset by what you said.
I know, Dad.
Mainly because some of it was true. And it really hit home. Marcus, You show me your ideas. And the good ones. We'll make them work, okay?
Together?
Together.
Dad, there's just one other thing.
What?
You know, I've said the Enterprise Trust had given us the loan.
Yeah.
Well, they haven't. They've given me the loan.
So you are trying to take over my business?
No, it has to be in my name.
What is that?
Well, you're too old, apparently.
I don't believe it. So when it all goes belly up, you'll have to pay it back. I think I'll drink to that.
Thank goodness for that. Right, where's the stripper?
I can't believe you said that.
I'm a new man. I don't do that sort of thing.
Yeah, that and we can't afford it.
Well, how much do people get paid for taking the kit off, then?
You wouldn't believe it. More than we get for an odd week's graft.
Just for taking the clothes off? She's still out there.
She really is a beautiful young girl, isn't she?
She certainly is. Even if she does get herself up to her elbows in debt.
She made a mistake. We've all made a few of them.
Come to bed, Faith. Big day tomorrow.
I can't let her go to bed thinking we don't love her.
She'd never think that.
Socially.
Nice one. Here, I'll take him. Hold his back leg. He won't bite. He just squeals a lot. That's it. Hold his back leg. All right, you got him.
Big Sam.
Hey, Matt's here.
How are you, Matt?
And this is his wife, Frankie. Hey,
welcome to Silver Town. Sorry about this. Come on.
Yeah, come on.
Oh,
get that broom.
Come on.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to St. Joseph's. We have come together in the presence of God to witness the marriage of Celeste and Marcus, to ask his blessing on them and to share in their joy.
I certainly did. Good old Brian.
Yeah, about 102.
Did you cry?
No.
I was allergic to the old pews.
Liar.
The bride and groom and the bridesmaids only, please. All the bridesmaids can throw. Here you go. I want the bridesmaids to throw the bouquets in the air on the count of three. Ready? One, two, three.
I don't think so.
Thanks for coming.
That was nothing.
It wasn't nothing. Not to me.
Have a wonderful life, Celeste.
Thanks, Mum. That must have been hard.
Wasn't as hard as I thought. He's not a monster, is he? Just a silly man, really.
Celeste? You all right? You wanted? Things are looking up. It's a great little world we live in. I'm happy as a bird since love looked up at me.
Now, before we hear from Marcus, I think we should all know where they're going on honeymoon first. Yeah. So, Marcus, Celeste, this present is for you. It's from Faith and I. Molly, the envelope, please.
They've booked us on a trip to go sailing around the Channel Islands.
Everyone's been giving us presents, and we thought we'd like to give you one back, just to prove that anything you can do, we can do better, and just to prove that I do sometimes like Dad's awful taste in music. Vicar, when you're ready.
Well, it's a full crew. They'll take you down the coast, anywhere you want to go. Champagne's chilling. So, all you have to do now is, I don't need to tell you that, do I?
Thank you.
Dad, I...
Come here. I'm proud of you, son.
To something.